Jenny, and I'm back because we're in the last week of our Thankful series, and we've had so much fun being thankful with all of you. And you know what? If you're new, we're thankful for you too. We want you to text in to this number, the word new and your name, because we send mail out every week to all of our friends, and we want you to start getting our mail too. So last time I was here, there was this owl that came in and kind of messed up our set. And I was pretty sure someone was playing a trick on us, and then I came today and there's this plastic owl here. And I know somebody is playing a trick on us, because how could this little owl do all that damage and leave us a note again? Big surprise, guys. I don't know who's doing this, but I want to find out. While you guys are listening to our song, I'm going to make a phone call and I'm going to figure out who this Wally person is and why they keep coming and messing up our set. And I wanna read the note, but first, I wanna pray with you. So if everybody can get nice and quiet for me. God, I thank you for each and every boy and girl watching this right now, and we thank you for your son Jesus and the sacrifice that he made for each and every one of us. We ask that you open our hearts and minds as we learn about you today, and we ask that you be with us as we go through our week. And in Jesus' name we pray, amen. Okay, boys and girls, I'm gonna make a phone call, and I think I'm gonna call Miss Tammy because she's good at finding stuff around here. And we'll be right back after the song.
Jesus, I'm thankful for all you've done. Jesus, I'm thankful for all you'll do. Find all I need. You got me dancing in everything. My heart is singing for you. Give me life. I long to praise you. I'm lifting you high.
love our thankful song, boys and girls. And you know what? I want to tell you what I'm thankful for this week. I am thankful for God's creation. I'm thankful for me. I'm thankful for all of you. I'm thankful for the mountains and the ocean and the flowers and the rocks and the grass. I love God's creation. And you know what? I think you're all ready to open this note, aren't you? So I'm going to go ahead and read what Wally left for us today. Hello, Kids Crossing. I am thankful for Jesus and that he came to rescue us. Do you know what I mean? Well, don't worry if you don't, because I left you another video to show you what I mean. Love, Wally, the Owl of Wisdom. Well, boys and girls, I know what Wally means, but I want to make sure you all do too. So we have a video and... It's Miss Tammy! Hello? You found Wally? Yes! It's okay. You don't have to come, but just bring Wally here. We want to meet her. Yes. Okay. Bye-bye. Boys and girls, Miss Tammy found Wally. So watch our video, and after the video, I'll come back and I'll have Wally here with me. Okay, we'll be right back.
God's story, Jesus' rescue. So part of God's story is about Jesus' rescue, and it begins like this. Remember how God told Adam not to eat from one tree in the Garden of Eden? God said, if you eat its fruit, you're sure to die. Unfortunately, Adam and Eve chose to disobey God. And that's when death and all the wrong things in the world began. Adam and Eve eventually died. And everyone who disobeys God, which is all of us, deserves the same punishment. But God loves us so much, he decided to rescue us by getting rid of death so we could be close to him forever again. He did it through his son, Jesus. It was a battle of death versus Jesus. And don't worry, kids, Jesus wins. First, Jesus had to meet death, which means he had to become a man and suffer and die like us, even though he had never done anything wrong. He did that. Then, 3 days after he died, some women who were friends with Jesus went to visit his grave. When they got there, the tomb was wide open and angels were standing nearby. One of them said, "He is risen." Right away, the women ran to tell Jesus' other disciples that the angel had said Jesus was alive. But their words sounded like nonsense. Imagine telling someone that pigs were flying or a frog had turned into a prince. They probably wouldn't believe you. Those things just don't happen. Anyway, crazy as it sounded, Jesus really was alive. And some people saw him and started to believe it. Like Mary Magdalene. When Mary first saw Jesus, she was crying and didn't recognize him. He said, "Why are you crying?" Mary replied, "They've taken my Lord away." Then Jesus said, "Mary." When he called her by name, Mary realized it was Jesus. Then Jesus showed up to two men who were headed to a place called Emmaus. They didn't recognize him at first either, and started telling him how sad they were about Jesus. They were pretty surprised when they suddenly realized that they were talking to Jesus. After the men understood he was alive, Jesus disappeared from their sight. Immediately, the same men went to find Jesus' other disciples, who were meeting in a room. While the men were announcing the good news, Jesus appeared in the room too. His disciples thought he was a ghost, but he wasn't. He showed them his scars and ate with them. They realized it really was Jesus. Jesus would appear to more than 500 people over the next 40 days, so there were plenty of people who knew the truth. Then Jesus went back to heaven by rising into the sky. People watched him until he was hidden by a cloud. Then two men in white appeared and said, "Jesus has been taken from you into heaven, but someday he will return from heaven in the same way you saw him go." Since Jesus took the punishment that we deserve, now nothing stands in between us and God. Anybody can become a part of God's family if we choose to believe that Jesus beat death and decide to follow him. Even though we still have to live in this world where we suffer and die, like Jesus did, the best part is, we can follow him and be a part of his story right now. And he's preparing a perfect home for his family to live in forever. And that's the story of Jesus' rescue. So, in case you missed it, here's the quick version. Adam and Eve disobeyed. They had to die. We all do wrong things. We deserve death. God rescued us. Jesus took our punishment. Jesus beat death. He went to heaven. We can be a part of God's family. And all that is a part of God's story.
Well, Wally, so nice to meet you. My name is Manny. We're so excited that you're here today. Are you scared?
Well, a little.
What's the matter?
Well, it's just, I didn't know if I was allowed to be here because I'm an owl and I'm not very special. And I know you teach Bible lessons here. And so I wanted to come, but well, that's why I said I was an owl of wisdom, because I wanted you to think I was special enough to be here.
Wally, we love everybody here at Kidz Crossing. You are so special. Do you know Jesus?
I do. He's my best friend.
Well, that is so awesome because of Jesus, it doesn't matter who we are, what we look like, what we know, who we know, none of that matters. And you know what? Here at Kidz Crossing, our purpose is to help kids meet and follow Jesus. And because Jesus welcomed everyone, we welcome everyone. And you know what, Wally? Jesus made you, Jesus made me, and he made all the boys and girls, and that makes us all special. And the Bible tells us in Luke, I'm going to tell you a Bible verse, okay? It's super easy. You could all probably memorize it right now with me. It's in Luke chapter 19, verse 10. And it says, "For the Son of Man came to seek and save the lost."
Of course, silly me. I knew that. And we're all lost.
Yes, at some point, Wally, we're all lost before we find Jesus. And I am so thankful, like our video that you left us, for Jesus' rescue.
You know what? I'm thankful for something else too. Do you want to know what it is?
I do.
I'm thankful for you. And I'm thankful for the boys and girls who are watching the videos at home. I've been watching the videos and I accepted Jesus into my life. And so, even though I'm not always wise, I accepted him into my life, and so I wanted to come and see what it was like here because it looked so fun.
Wally, we are so glad you came. We're so glad you watched the videos and that you accepted Jesus. That makes us so happy here. We have a celebration. It's pretty awesome, just like they do in heaven. And you know what, Wally? Do we want to give the boys and girls a chance to ask Jesus into their life?
Yes, let's do.
Okay. So boys and girls, we're gonna pray, and if you've never prayed the prayer to ask Jesus into your life, you can pray right along with me. So we're gonna ask everybody to get quiet and close their eyes. God, I admit that I'm a sinner. I know I do things wrong. And I believe that you sent your son Jesus for me because I'm not perfect, but he was. And I believe that he died on the cross, and I believe that he rose again, and that he's in heaven, and he's waiting for me. And I ask you, Jesus, to come into my life, be a part of my life, walk with me, and be with me as I go through every single day. And in your name we pray, Jesus, amen.
Amen.
Yes, we're so excited. Thanks for being with us, Wally. So boys and girls, if you prayed that prayer and you accepted Jesus into your life, we want you to text this number and let us know. Text your name and that you chose Jesus, and we've got something special we want to send to you. You know what, Wally? I want to know where you live. Can I come over?
Yes, come over, Manny.
Okay, awesome. Well, boys and girls, we'll see you next time. Bye-bye.
Bye.
About anything, instead pray about everything. Tell God what you need and thank him for all he has done. Don't worry, instead pray. Don't worry, instead pray. Guard your hearts and minds as you live, as you live, as you live in Christ Jesus. Don't worry, instead pray. Don't worry, instead pray. Instead, instead pray.